Good evening, Hananoth. What business entrepreneurs are to the economy, social entrepreneurs are to social change. They are the driven, creative individuals who question the status quo, exploit new opportunities, refuse to give up, and remake the world for the better. Welcome to the webinar series titled Business Models Against COVID-19, organized by the Postgraduate and Research Department of Commerce in association with IQHC Maharajas College, Ernakulam. By seeking the blessings of the Almighty, let's move on to the session. First, I invite Dr. Suresh VN, Head of the Department of Commerce and convener of the event, to speak a few words about the theme of the webinar series.
Good evening. I am really happy to see that the Department of Commerce is organizing a webinar series on contemporary commerce topic. We know that today's webinar topic is the current one, social entrepreneurship, an innovative path for sustainable development. The key speaker of this today's webinar is Dr. Minimal MC, Associate Professor, Rajagiri School of Social Sciences, Department of Business Administration, Rajagiri. We know that for sustainable development of every nation requires social entrepreneurship. There is a growing disconnect between companies and societal needs. In order to bridge the gap between societal needs and companies' goals, there must be social entrepreneurship. This is the area where we have to concentrate more. Without having social connect, without having social entrepreneurship, corporates cannot connect with the society. Social entrepreneurship is nothing but business for social cause. See, in modern times, every business should have a social connect. Every business should have a social dimension. This is a current topic. Today, we are very fortunate that Dr. Minimal MC is an expert in the field. It's a good track record in academic activities or academic field. I'm really happy that Dr. Minimal MC consented to deliver a talk on this current topic, social entrepreneurship. I take this opportunity to welcome Dr. Minimal MC for this webinar hosted by Department of Commerce, Maharajas College, Ernakulam. I also like to thank Mary Sudha P, Assistant Professor, Department of Commerce, Maharajas College, Ernakulam, as a coordinator of today's webinar. I also take this opportunity to thank all the team members of Department of Commerce, Maharajas College, and our research scholars who have contributed a lot for make things happen. Thank you all and thank you very much. I once again thank all the organizers of the program. Thank you.
Now, I invite Ms. Mary Sudha P, Assistant Professor, Department of Commerce and coordinator of the event, to introduce the resource person.
They who invest the financial resources to change the world in the most positive way. Very good evening to one and all. And welcome back to the third webinar in the webinar series titled Social Entrepreneurship, an Innovative Path to Sustainable Development. With due respect, I invite Dr. Suresh VN, our HOD of department, our resource person, Dr. Minimal MC, Associate Professor, Research Dean in Dajpuri College of Social Sciences, panel members, and all participants to the webinar. Let me introduce our resource person, Dr. Binimol, who possesses more than 15 years of teaching and research experience, has authored 4 books, published more than 45 research papers in high-ranking peer-reviewed journals, including Scopus Q1, Q3, Q4, ABDC, B and C category publications, presented more than 15 research papers in international conferences, serving as the editor-in-chief of Raspberry Management Journal, an international journal published by the Emerald Publishing House, UK, a reviewer of various Scopus indexed journals, served as the approved PhD supervisor in Christ University, Bangalore, and Paradia University. I'm stopping here because her profile is such a lengthy one. In short, we can say that within a short span of time, she had conquered the academic heights. And wish you, ma'am, may you reach the glory of academic excellence. Another way of introducing Mini Ma'am is she's the wife of our Dr. Makesh KG, the PhD supervisor in Maharajas College, and assistant professor at Government College, Tripunithara. Once again, on behalf of the Commerce Department, Maharajas, IQAC, DQAC, and all the participants, I invite you, ma'am, to handle the session. Thank you. Hello, ma'am.
Thank you, Mary Sudha ma'am, for the brief introduction. Hope my voice is audible to you.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so can I start?
Yes, ma'am, it's audible.
Can I start?
Hello, sir. Okay, sir.
Can I start? Hope my voice is audible to you. Can I start?
Yes, ma'am.
Audible.
Is the screen visible?
Yes, ma'am, visible.
Is my screen visible to you?
Yes, ma'am, it's visible.
So, good evening to one and all. I'm here to share with you inspiring stories of some social entrepreneurs all over the world. I hope all of you agree with me if I say there is increasing demand for social services these days. This is because so many disadvantaged groups are present throughout the world. For example, people with disabilities, convicts, homeless, individuals with substance abuse histories, and many more. There is chronic underemployment in the world. And there are many emerging global problems like systemic poverty, AIDS, terrorism, repeated natural disasters, etc., which require immediate attention. All the more, the cost of public services is climbing like anything. Availability of governmental and charitable funds is on a decrease. Hope all of you are aware of Professor Muhammad Yunus' story. In 1974, in a Bangladesh village, he observed that craftspeople were skilled but limited by their credit availability. So he identified a solution for this. the solution of micro loans with no collateral and low interest, which could actually improve their lives. When he experimented with these micro loans, he find out that there is very high loan repayment. Thus, he ventured into the creation of Grameen Bank, which has got nationwide adoption. And in 2006, Professor Yunus won the Nobel Peace Prize, and Grameen Bank is a famous model of social entrepreneurship from then onwards. I told the story of Professor Yunus just to invite your attention to the various solutions for the social problems that I have mentioned earlier. We can reduce poverty through creating jobs. We can develop community trust and strengthen local networks. We can make communities self-sufficient, create self-esteem, self-worth, and communities confident. We can even think of increasing the tax base to support various services, create markets for products produced locally rather than importing them. We can retain local wealth. Also, we can innovate and create. So, what is the meaning of creativity and innovation here? It involves offering a new product or service, developing new processes or technology for producing or delivering an existing product, service, program, or project, delivering existing product, service, or program to a new or previously underserved market, use a new source of supply of raw material and resources, design a new type of organization structure, utilize new source of labor or other production inputs. We can even think of creating new funding models as part of creativity and innovation. So let me come to the point, what is social entrepreneurship? It is the process of developing innovative new organizations to address social, cultural, and environmental problems. And who is a social entrepreneur? Social entrepreneur is somebody who takes up a pressing social problem and meets it with an innovative or path-breaking solution. Individuals with innovative solutions to society's social, cultural, and environmental challenges are called social entrepreneurs. Let me tell you about the core values of a social entrepreneur. A social entrepreneur should possess creativity in the sense that he or she should be able to provide something new, something creative, provide something unique, which is not already given by somebody else. A social entrepreneur should have passion towards his goal. He should be a leader. So, according to you, who is a leader? A leader is a person who can get things done by others by showing his own example. So a social entrepreneur should be like that only. By showing his own example or her own example, he or she should be able to get things done by others. He should have drive in his mind, in the sense that there should be a spark in the mind of a social entrepreneur. So even at times of difficulties, that spark will burn. That will actually push him towards the goal he or she actually wanted to achieve. And finally, a social entrepreneur should be a person who is self-motivated rather than waiting for somebody else to come and motivate him or her towards the goal. Let us look at the anatomy of the social entrepreneur. Social entrepreneur always see things in a different way. So, there is economic intelligence in a social entrepreneur. they are socially motivated. People and their fundamental needs are at the focus of a social entrepreneur. Social entrepreneurs should be courageous in the sense that they can make even very difficult decisions, overcoming difficult problems. He or she should have quick and alternative thinking, capability to quickly foresee new business opportunities and to create new ways of doing things. So what makes a social entrepreneur different from a traditional entrepreneur? As all of you know, traditional entrepreneur is always motivated by money, the profit of the business. Whereas social entrepreneur's focus is always on handholding others while making money. Social entrepreneur is motivated by social gain, whereas traditional entrepreneur is motivated by financial gain. Social entrepreneur is expected to be highly innovative and creative with lower levels of self-interest, whereas traditional entrepreneurs should possess higher levels of self-interest. Social entrepreneurs should have higher levels of social conscience, whereas traditional entrepreneurs should have lower levels of social conscience. Both of them are risk takers, but social entrepreneurs assume higher levels of risk taking because there is no proven track of business with him. Traditional entrepreneurs are more profit driven, whereas social entrepreneurs are social impact driven. Let me tell you the story of Ashoka. Have you heard of Ashoka? Ashoka is the world's largest network of leading social entrepreneurs and ranks among the top five NGOs of the world. Founded by Bill Wrighton in 1981, Ashoka is developing social entrepreneurship among people through their various programs like Ashoka Fellowships, Ashoka Changemakers Program, Ashoka Youth Ventures, and all. The first ever social entrepreneur to be selected as an Ashoka Fellow was Gloria D'Souza from India in 1982, who revolutionized the system of learning in classrooms. Coming to the characteristics of social entrepreneurs, a social entrepreneur should possess curiosity, inspiration, resourcefulness, pragmatism, adaptability, openness to collaboration, and persistence. These are considered as the seven essential characteristics of social entrepreneurs across the world. Let me explain these points with the inspiring stories of some social entrepreneurs. Have you heard of Shakti Apparel? An apparel brand for empowering women in rural India and powering ethical clothing consumption. Shakti is a venture aiming to partner with stitching centers in rural villages of India to empower women and influence economic growth. They influence both the production side and consumption side of apparel supply chain. They influence the production side by creating employment for rural women. They influence the consumption side by influencing the decision of consumers when it comes to buying of ethical apparel. You know how the founders of Shakti Apparel launched their venture? Before they start their venture, for a long time, they actually work with villagers in rural India just to learn about their lifestyles. This is what I told you as curiosity. Have you heard of Evan? A social entrepreneurship with a mission to tell time through touch. Even founder Hyun-Soo Kim was a graduate student at MIT when he learned of his problem through a friend who is blind. Even created a sleek, modern watch that more people can use. Designed for touch when you can't easily use sight. For example, during a meeting, in a movie theater, or due to vision impairment. When he learned that his blind friend had no way to tell time, the founder of Even set out a mission to design an effective solution to his friend's problem. Best example for inspiration. Inspired by the problem of his friend, he started the venture. Let me tell you about Paga Apparel. Apparels made of alpaca wool, one of the most sustainable materials on earth. You know what is alpaca? Alpaca is an animal innate to the environment, and hence they are inherently sustainable. All their products and experiences support a simple mission: consumers and creators made equal. From sourcing the materials from local farmers to using natural dyes to empowering women weavers, the entire system works in synergy with nature, and they strive to be conscious of every part of their business. When he needed capital, you know what the founder of Paga Apparel did? He started an alpaca petting zoo at a well-known restaurant to raise early stage funds for his venture. This is what is resourcefulness: the capacity to identify alternative sources of resources. A social entrepreneur should possess resourcefulness. Chris Cody, the founder, started Paga after taking a year to work in South America. He returned back to the US with an alpaca sweater. Everywhere he took it, people would always ask about the sweater and where they could actually find one. So he remembered Peruvian women who had sold him the sweater and saw a gap to bridge. So he returned on a one-way flight to Cusco and trekked around Peru and eventually building a team of women weavers. Only a social entrepreneur can do this, because he had to experience so many difficulties on the path, and he had to identify the resources for starting such a venture. At the time, he cannot actually depend on his own resources, rather he could actually search for alternative resources for the business. Be As You Wear, another brand. World's leading brand for people who value softness, style, and shared responsibility to ensure equal access to education and well-being for every kid born. They work to reform systems that put youth at risk by taking small steps, such as performing small group education interventions and selling hoodies to fund her work. This is an example for pragmatism. A social entrepreneur should be pragmatic. Social entrepreneur should be pragmatic while doing the business. Have you heard of Salty Girl Seafood? It's a startup launched by fish-loving social entrepreneurs. A Santa Barbara-based business that believes that everyone has the right to accurate information about their seafood products. Salty Girl wants to help their customers, support the fishermen and communities that promote sustainable practices around the world. Founded by Nora Eddy and Laura Johnson, while studying at the Brent School of Environmental Science and Management at Santa Barbara. The company is into selling of portioned, pre-marinated, sustainable fish bought from small fisheries distributed through supermarkets. You know, initially, Salty Girl was planning to create a platform to link fisheries to chefs, but eventually they pivoted to selling sustainable, traceable fish directly to consumers. An example for adaptability. There is a venture called Refugee Investment Network. The RIN is the first impact investing and blended finance collaborative dedicated to creating durable solutions to global forced migration. They connect investors with refugee ventures, build the field of refugee investment, and advocate for more inclusive refugee policies with the ultimate goal of creating quality jobs, economic growth, and measurable improvements to the livelihoods of millions of refugees and host community members. RIN partnered with Village Capital to offer an investment readiness tool designed for refugee entrepreneurs. This is what I told you as openness to collaborate. A social entrepreneur should always open for collaborations with others so that they can take advantage of the market situations. Kapama Gogopa Incorporated in Philippines, KI, the first and only systematized institutionalized Muslim volunteer sending organization in the Philippines. Working for better cross-cultural relationships, community empowerment, and poverty alleviation for peace and development. Kapama Gogopa in Philippines means sharing or helping others. They inspire women to become peace builders. KI overcome all the obstacles to bring peace to communities in Philippines through their persistence. Let me tell you about some inspiring stories of Indian social entrepreneurs. Have you heard of Chef Schools? An organization dedicated to offering education to the most disadvantaged girls in India. Urvashi Sahni, the founder, has worked with over 900 schools and changed the lives of 150,000 girls directly and 270,000 girls indirectly with her program. She was rightly felicitated with the Social Entrepreneur of the Year Award in 2017 for her selfless act of dedication and passion. You know what she is doing? She identified girl childs from rural parts of India and motivate them to go to school, who cannot go to school because of so many problems, maybe because there is nobody to finance their education, maybe because there are siblings to be looked after by them, or even the family members are not interested in sending these girls to school. So by identifying such girls, she actually motivated them to go to chef schools, and chef schools are working during their convenient times. Now, chef educate over 6,000 students and trains over 8,000 teachers and works with over 150,000 students, teachers, young women, indirectly through partnership with social ventures. Selco, a company rendering sustainable energy source to rural regions of the country. This project was the first rural solar financing program in India. Till date, Selco has contributed over 120,000 installations and has more than 25 operating retail and service centers in Karnataka alone. You know, how did they work? They consider poor as the partners, innovators, inventors, and enterprise owners in order to develop their solutions. And their solutions are truly inclusive and not designed based on the assumptions of what the poor need. You may have heard of goals. Founded by Anshu Gupta, an Indian social entrepreneur, awarded Magsaysay for his work on transforming the culture of giving in India and for highlighting material as a sustainable development resource for the poor. You know what they are doing? This organization collect used clothing from urban area, sort them, fix them, repair them, and later distribute it among the poor and needy. The relief work done by Goonj during the times of natural calamities in Gujarat, Tamil Nadu, and Kerala have been highly acknowledged. And Anshu Gupta is popularly known as the clothing man of India. You know, they will not thrash the material that they got, rather they use every shreds of those used materials. And now they are making over 100 different products like purses, fancy bags, file folders, mats, etc. made out of torn jeans, obsolete audio tapes, one-side used paper, etc. And essentially, these products are crafted and designed by women from the nearby slums, thus also providing an employment opportunity for them. People Tree Ventures of Santosh Parulekar is working to create job opportunities for unemployed youth in rural India. They provide skill development training to youth, skill development in the areas of plumbing, painting, electrical, waterproofing, tiles and marble fixing, fold ceiling, etc. Operating since 2007, People Tree has trained over 1,500 workers and intends to open training centers pan-India in the coming years. You may have heard of Reng Sutra, an apparel brand again. Sumita Ghosh is the founder of Ashoka Changemakers, an open-ended platform for social innovation that was one of its kind in the world. Sumita aims to revive the craftsmanship and talent that is unharnessed in rural India and aims to provide them with their deserving recognition. You know, when she was planning to start Reng Sutra, she is not having any money with her. You know what she did? She actually wanted to raise loan from financial institutions, but then no financial institution was giving her a loan because of her lower credit worthiness. So what she did is she thought of making the artisans the shareholders of her venture. So 1,000 artisans invested rupees 1,000 each, providing her with the seed money required for her business. So she started Reng Sutra, a retail chain from Fab India, and it turned out to be a huge success. Frontier Markets of Ajayda Shah, who works with a mission to empower rural India. She started at the gross level and aims to provide the best of technological solutions to the remote villages in India at the cheapest price possible. Frontier Market supplies solar energy powered products to rural India at an extremely affordable cost. The company has sold over 10,000 solar solutions until now, and there is no stopping them until they light the remotest corners of the country. Sulabh International, founded in 1970 by Dr. Bindeshwar Pathak, an NGO working on areas such as sanitation, water for all, community toilets, and dignity of manual scavengers. He introduced the concept of pay and use public toilets in India, made drinking water affordable at 1 rupee per liter, built and maintains 2,489 toilets in slums across urban area, 19,603 toilet blocks in 6,241 schools. So, let me just ask you, why this social entrepreneurship business model is widely accepted? Because an increasing proportion of the world's population now believes that their employer should do the right thing when it comes to important social issues. With a growing sense of civic responsibility, spreading amongst younger generations, social enterprises have become the de facto choice for many aspiring entrepreneurs. This is especially true in smaller economies that are grappling with environmental and social challenges. So, what is the model is all about? Business as a tool to solve social issues. That is the model. There are three models of social enterprises: model one, model two, and model three. Model one is called the profit generator model. It's all about engaging in a trading activity that has no direct social impact, make a profit, and then transfer some or all that profit to another activity that does have direct social impact. Model two, which is called the trade-off model, is carrying out a trading activity that does have direct social impact, but manage always a trade-off between producing financial return and social impact. Whereas model three, the lockstep model, is engaging in a trading activity that not only has direct social impact, but also generate a financial return in direct correlation to the social impact created. Let me tell you some examples. The profit generated model, all the for-profit businesses with CSR programs are examples for the profit generator model. Say, for example, ethical bottled water companies, which give a percentage of their profit to developing charitable projects. Let us come to the trade-off model. Microfinance organizations or firms that employ the disabled or disadvantaged people, all are examples of trade-off model where their focus is on social impact along with making money. But if you ask a question to them, can you increase the social impact of the firm by decreasing the financial returns? The answer will be yes. So that is a trade-off model. You can always compromise your profit for a social impact in trade-off model. The third model, the lockstep model, the best example is cooperatives. So if you ask the same question to them, can you increase the social impact by decreasing the financial returns, their answer should be no, because it is a model three type organization where they look at both social impact and financial returns. So they cannot actually compromise on their financial returns. At the same time, they focus on social impact also. So these are the three recognized models of social enterprises. So that's all from my side. Thank you. So the floor is open for questions now. If you have any questions, you can ask.
Thank you, ma'am. Let's move on to the interactive session.
Ma'am, I would like to ask whether there are well-known social entrepreneurs in India and how are they going on?
Pardon, can you repeat?
The social entrepreneurs in India, with respect to India, can you throw light on their activities, some of their activities and how they are going about it?
So let me tell you about, what I have shown you in the examples of these so many people, starting from Chef School to the Sulabh International, all of them are working in India. And to tell you another example, like all of you have heard about Akshay Patra, no? Akshay Patra. Akshay Patra is again another social entrepreneurship model which is working in India. So social entrepreneurs, as I told you earlier, because their focus is on social impact, they are not actually worried about the financial returns that they are making from the business. But the thing is that they need money for their survival. So they actually wanted to make only that much. So their focus is on only that much financial returns. And especially in Kerala, you know, so many social entrepreneurship ventures are happening through the self-help group missions. Like, say, for example, we have so many BUD school initiatives where these children with mental disabilities are actually motivated to be learned. Okay. So, if so many things are happening in the social entrepreneurship front in India and especially in Kerala, but thing is that popularity is not that much. Whereas in foreign countries, social entrepreneurs, they try to popularize their business also. But in India, they are not coming to the limelight.
Ma'am?
Are these entrepreneurs supported by the government, ma'am?
Pardon?
Hello, ma'am.
Can I ask the question?
Hello. Ma'am, one question is in the chat box that what criteria can I distinguish social entrepreneurs from the registered entrepreneurs list offered by DIC?
Okay. So what you can do is DICs, they provide the list of entrepreneurs registered with them. So what you can do is basically you can apply a filter there. As I told you earlier, their business model can be the filter there. That should be the way, the most logical way of distinguishing, identifying social entrepreneurship ventures from the total number of entrepreneurs is by applying the filter of business models. So I told you about the three different business models which social entrepreneurs are popularly using. So you can actually check the business models they are using, and based on these models, if they belong to any of these three models, model one, that is they do business and give some part of the profit for CSR activities. Model two, they do social impact businesses with a focus on profit, so they try to manage both their financial focus and social focus, and they can even compromise on the money part of it because their major focus is on social thing. And third model is by making money along with social impact, so they cannot actually compromise on their profit. So by looking at these business models, you can actually distinguish between social entrepreneurs and other entrepreneurs.
Okay, ma'am. Next question.
Yeah.
Why there is no live examples of social entrepreneurs in Kerala?
Yeah, this is what I told you earlier. Like, in Kerala, there are so many social entrepreneurs working, but then some most of them are not working under the banner of, say, like self-help groups or Kudumbasri missions. So somehow they are not coming to the light. That is what.
Okay, ma'am.
If you take the case of India as such, social entrepreneurship is in a nascent stage. So people are doing so many things, but there are yet to be done to make them popular. Yes.
Okay, ma'am. Next question is, can you please explain about the criteria you used in your study for distinguishing social entrepreneurs from the list of entrepreneurs?
Yeah. So what I did is I took the list of micro, small and medium entrepreneurs from this list registered in Kerala. And then what I did is I classified them based on the nature of their business. So after classifying them based on the nature of their business, what I did is I applied the filter, as I told you earlier, their business models. What is the kind of business model they are doing? And then I selected only those entrepreneurs which are coming within the purview of these business models. That is how I did it.
Okay, ma'am. Next question is, did you find any particular institution more helpful for the social entrepreneurs?
Yeah, they are almost all the institutions related to entrepreneurship are now offering support to social entrepreneurs also, like say for example SIDBI, like NABARD, Confederation of Indian Industry, FICCI, all of them have a separate wing for supporting social entrepreneurs. And you know, recently SEBI has floated an investment policy to recognize the social venture funds. And Incube Connect Fund in Gujarat is recognized as the first social venture in India. So what I'm telling you is, even SEBI is offering their support to social entrepreneurs, and specifically focusing on the development of social entrepreneurs, we have so many incubators. So many institutions are running incubators for social entrepreneurs alone. Some examples are like, okay, we have Center for Innovation, Incubation and Entrepreneurship, which is run by IIM Ahmedabad. We have Rural Technology Business Incubators run by IIT Madras. We have Deshpande Foundation in Karnataka, ALC India, Jaga in Bangalore. So many such institutions are now providing incubation support to social entrepreneurs. Even Niti Aayog, government through Niti Aayog is providing support to social entrepreneurs these days. Is that clear? Am I answered your question?
Yes, it was clear, ma'am.
Okay.
Ma'am, can you say what are the challenges these entrepreneurs face actually in the present scenario?
Yeah.
What challenges are ahead of these entrepreneurs? Because they are focusing not much on profit.
Correct.
So there might be many challenges.
Okay.
Can you name a few?
Yeah. The major challenges are related to the nature of the business itself, because they don't have any idea like whether they can sustain in the market, whether people will accept it, or will they have the sufficient funds to support their activities. They don't have any such guarantee. So that is a major risk. Also, there are not proven business models for social entrepreneurs, because all these social entrepreneurs are working on different areas. So like in the case of other entrepreneurs, if you ask them, okay, what is your business model, you can always show a history of a past model which is proven to be a success. But in the case of social entrepreneurs, entrepreneurship that is not there. So they have to actually prove that this business idea was a success. But that is a major challenge faced by them.
Thank you.
Ma'am, there is one more question.
Huh?
Where can I find your study for reference?
Yeah. My study on this question.
What of thanks for it? ഞാനിപ്പോ അയച്ചിട്ടുണ്ട്, വാട്സപ്പിൽ അയച്ചിട്ടുണ്ട്. ഞാൻ എഴുതിയ സാധനം.
ഓക്കെ, മൈ സ്റ്റഡി വാസ് ആക്ച്വലി സപ്പോർട്ടഡ് ബൈ ഇന്ത്യൻ കൗൺസിൽ ഓഫ് സോഷ്യൽ സയൻസ് റിസർച്ചേഴ്സ്. സോ ദേ ഹാവ് ഓൾറെഡി പബ്ലിഷ്ഡ് ഇറ്റ് ഇൻ ദെയർ റെപ്പോസിറ്ററി, ബിക്കോസ് ദ ഫുൾ സ്റ്റഡി ഇസ് പബ്ലിഷ്ഡ് ദെയർ. ആൻഡ് ഐ ഹാവ് ഈവൻ പബ്ലിഷ്ഡ് സം പേപ്പേഴ്സ് ബേസ്ഡ് ഓൺ ദ സ്റ്റഡി. ബട്ട് ദെൻ ഇൻ ദോസ് സ്റ്റഡീസ് യു ക്യാൻ ഓൺലി സീ എ പാർട്ട് ഓഫ് ദി സ്റ്റഡി. ദ എൻറ്റയർ സ്റ്റഡി ഈസ് ആക്ച്വലി അവൈലബിൾ ഇൻ ദ റെപ്പോസിറ്ററി ഓഫ് ഐ സി എസ് എസ് ആർ.
Okay, ma'am. I think there are no more questions. So we have come to the end of the interactive session. I invite Dr. Sudish Kumar K, Assistant Professor, Department of Commerce, to propose the vote of thanks.
I think Sudish sir, his net is low. I can go ahead, I suppose. Sudish sir, are you here?
Hello.
Are you here?
Swapna means, can you tell?
Yes. So it's all right. So we are in the third episode or third webinar of our webinar series, that is Business Models Amidst COVID-19. And this particular session handled by Dr. Minimal MC, it was very effective. And as you have all heard from her, she has effectively answered all those questions, and also a wonderful presentation also. We are enriched by your knowledge, ma'am, and it was really wonderful to have you here today for this webinar. I thank you on behalf of the IQAC and the PG Department of Commerce, the Research Department of Commerce, for being with us, and Rajagiri being a prestigious institution and taking time out to be here and deliver this particular topic, which is very relevant in today's scenario, and very effectively handling this session throughout. I extend heartfelt gratitude to you, ma'am, for being here with us. Thank you, ma'am. And the webinar series could not have been made possible without the support of the team headed by our HOD, Suresh sir. His unflinching support and cooperation throughout the series has been the guiding factor for us. Thank you, sir, for being here throughout. And this particular series would not have been possible without the research scholars of the Commerce Department. And I heartfelt my gratitude to Honey, to Saumya, to Blessy, to every research scholar who are behind this venture. Particular thanks to the coordinator of this webinar, Mary Sudha teacher. She has taken great pains and has done many things to host this particular webinar today. Thank you, teacher, for doing everything possible and being here throughout. My thanks to Santosh sir. He is the IQAC coordinator. He has been there throughout the webinar series, supporting us in spite of his busy schedule. Thank you, Santosh sir, for helping us throughout this particular program. The DQAC coordinator, Sauta teacher, all the team members of the Department of Commerce, Basula teacher, Preeti miss, Sudhir sir, they are all behind this. This teamwork would not have been possible without the support of each and every one. And a big salute and thank you to all those who are watching this particular program of our webinar, that is Business Models Amidst since COVID-19. We expect your cooperation throughout the webinar that will be conducted in this particular series. Thank you all once again. Thank you very much.
So, let me thank the entire organizing team for giving me this opportunity. Being with the faculty and students of Maharaja's College itself is a pride moment. Let me thank the entire organizing team, especially Suresh sir, Sudhir sir, Mary Sudha ma'am, Swapna ma'am, and all the members involved in organizing this webinar series, and faculty members of Commerce Department and the entire IQAC team of Maharaja's College. Thank you once again.
Thank you. Thank you, Shalini.
Honey.
Hi, shall we move?
Yes.
Okay.